What's going on, guys? Welcome back to episode 9. Manic Badger here, and today we've got a very, very special episode for you. It's not just myself doing the commentary, we're going to do the accents challenge, but we've got Drunken Wanderer here to help us out. Do you want to say hello to the folks, Drunken Wanderer?
Hello, folks. How's it going?
So we've got a game against Crystal Palace here in the Premier League. It's a big, big game. We need to get the points again, and we're going to jump straight into the fixture. So what we've done, as you can see on the table, we're 17th currently, but if we get a point, we'll be able to leapfrog up to mid-table. We've mainly got Højfelt to continue his form, and we've also got Asante up front with Lambert. So what do you think about that team, Wanderer?
Well, I've seen you've left Osvaldo on the bench. It's a good move. He's not having a great season this season, and I think that's the best place for him at the moment.
Wise words there, wise words. Osvaldo, the man in a rut, and he can't score, but luckily we've got the goal machine that is Ricky Lambert still playing for us. So Southampton gained possession from the start here. They're passing out to Shaw, he's made an appearance, and we've got Bakali as well. Nice little bit of 1-2 play. What are your predictions for the game, Wanderer?
Oh, it's hard to tell. I mean, Cardiff aren't playing very well either, to be honest. I think they're lower than you in the league, aren't they?
Yeah.
So I think you've got a good shot, mate. I think maybe it's your best shot you've got this season to rack up some points. That's all I'm saying myself.
And the ball falls to Crystal Palace here, and it comes off the post, and they clear it really close there. Unfortunately, it doesn't go wide, but Crystal Palace with the ball, sliding in, Southampton trying to get rid of the ball. It's whipped in. Who's that? Oh, good save.
Great save.
Great save by Boruch.
Squeaky bum time there, my friend. Squeaky bum time.
Crystal Palace still have possession here. Southampton trying to get a little bit of pressure relieved here as Palace are attacking with Puncheon, who's on loan from Southampton, remember. Shamak with the ball. Cleared out, kind of.
That is some sloppy defending, I must say.
But Asante brings the ball, he can't play it out. It's picked off by Crystal Palace, and Southampton are on the back foot once again. Jedinak!
Great goal. Can't take anything away from the goal. It's a wonderful through ball. I mean, nothing could have stopped that. No one.
Shocking defending by Southampton's part. Letting the through ball go. Jedinak gets the ball to his feet, strikes it across the face of goal. And it's 1-0 to Crystal Palace.
He was never going to miss that badge. Never.
Let's see what Southampton can do. We're going to try and press higher up the pitch. Try and press Crystal Palace, rather, into making a mistake. But Crystal Palace have the ball at the moment with Bolasie as Wanyama wins it in midfield. He passes out to Asante. Asante out wide to Lallana. Lallana, what can he do? He's going to play it through. Asante whips it across. Wanyama! Yes! Goal!
Great response. That's what you needed. That is definitely what you just needed.
The big man, Victor Wanyama, comes up with a cracking header across the face of goal. But what a delivery by Asante. What do you think of him so far, Wanderer?
I see he's got a bit of promise to him. I mean, he's making stuff happen.
It's gone through the defender and Ricky Lambert's there. He scores. That's 2-1 to Southampton. Some shocking defending. Through ball from Lallana, I think it was. Comes right to the feet of Lambert. Let's have a look at that again.
Let's check that replay out. Oh, that is cheese, sir.
That is just gone right through the defender. Didn't even make a flinch or anything like that. And here we go. 2-1 up, 45 minutes. Let's see if we can hold on to the lead until half-time. Make that team talk a lot easier. What do you think are the things that Southampton need to concentrate on in the second half?
Keeping position of the ball, I think, is the main object that you need to work on. And if you keep the ball, you win the game.
So let's have a look at them stats. We've got pretty even, really. Crystal Palace with 4 shots on target and Southampton with 3, but we've got those 2 crucial goals so far. Let's see what else can happen as Crystal Palace have possession here again. We've got them on the counter-attack. A through ball for Puncheon, but Shaw's tracking back. What can he do? Can he get a... It's in the box. Shamak! Oh! Gets a header in. Shamak just can't stop scoring.
Having a great season.
Great season at Crystal Palace. I bet the Arsenal fans are bitter they let him go.
Especially with their injuries lately.
Yeah, with all their strikers out, maybe it wasn't the wisest move as Shamak nets the ball. And it equalises the score 2-2. Let's see what Southampton can do as a response. The ball's played through. Wanyama running things in midfield with Schneiderlin. What do you think of those two in midfield? Good partnership?
It's a great pairing. It's a great pairing, I mean.
Oh, we've got Lambert struggling to get the player off. He goes, yes! Lambert with a shot. Holds off the players. Lovely bit of strength, that, isn't it?
Some serious gym work going on there. You spent a lot of time in that gym building that core strength to muscle through defenders like that. Unbelievable.
And good tidy finish, bottom right hand corner, and that gives Southampton the lead. It's 3-2 against Crystal Palace. What do you think about the overall play? Do you think the chances are coming regular, or what are we lacking in depth, should we say?
I mean, it's hard to tell. I mean, it's the first game of yours that I've seen, and I'm only seeing snippets.
Big fan.
You know what I mean? But I like your play. You're spreading the play. You're crossing it in. You're using the strength that you've got in the middle. And yeah, it's working.
Lallana with a cross. And Wanyama hits it first time. But it goes straight to the keeper over there. And Julian Speroni's able to get hands on it. Got a corner here. Lambert whips it in. Wanyama! Oh, that's a great header. Wanyama with another header. Two goals for Victor Wanyama. The assist by Lambert. And I think Lambert's also scored the other two goals. Man of the match so far for you?
It's got to be Lambert. It's got to be. His vision, his finishing, it's just second to none in this league at the moment. Beautiful.
Okay, so Southampton making a substitution. We're bringing on Emmanuel Frimpong and Daniel Ragatsu for Schneiderlin and Asante. What do you think about these new signings that the manager's bringing in? Well, myself, what I'm bringing in. Do you think they're any good?
Frimpong.
The
man's a legend. When he was at Arsenal, he was absolutely awesome when he got off the bench for them 2 minutes a year. He really showed his sprite.
So Frimpong plays the ball through there, comes through to Ragatsu, but unfortunately he doesn't fall to the right place. Southampton's still pressurising here with Frimpong in the midfield with Wanyama. It's one of my favourite midfields.
That is
good,
a great
pairing.
Great pairing.
Good strength and aggression. As Crystal Palace are looking to attack here, great, great defensive clearance there by, I'm not sure, I think that was Fonte or perhaps Hoyfeld, but Ragatsu's got the ball here. Ward-Prowse has come on for us as well. Wanyama plays it to Lambert. What a pairing. They've had an absolute brilliant game so far. Ball's picked off there by Crystal Palace. Palace on the counter attack here. Josh Hoyfeld with a crunching tackle. Ward-Prowse sprays it, but it's intercepted. Poor pass over there. Any of the other players, any youngsters that have caught your eye, potential England starlets in the future?
Who would you be suggesting?
Well, we've got Adam Lallana, who's just made his cap, as well as Ricky Lambert. And the shot over there, whoa, that was really close. Wanyama nearly gets his hat-trick as he has a shot with his left foot. He gets the ball back of Lambert, them two linking up again, and the ball goes just wide.
Yeah, to come back to what you were saying, Lambert deserves a shot because Danny Welbeck isn't up to par lately. And you've been showing that Ricky Lambert's got skills. He's got what he needs to have.
We've also got Ward-Prowse, who's a young midfielder, and Luke Shaw. What do you think of them, potentially? We've also got the other fullback, Callum Chambers, who plays right back. He's fairly decent. But we're going to talk that a little bit about that in the aftermatch debate a little bit. But that's a full-time whistle. Big win for Southampton. 4-2 overall over Crystal Palace. Two goals for Lambert, two goals for Wanyama. And we're going to have a quick look. So we had 8 shots overall, 5 on target against Palace's 6-4. So a really close game. But Southampton just the more clinical. Man of the match rating, awarded by our special guest, goes to Ricky Lambert. What did you like about his plays today?
His presence, mainly. Every time we got the ball, you could see the defenders shaking. And that was the most critical part of it, to be honest. They know what he was coming against, and they were scared.
Okay, so thanks very much for the special guest. Hopefully you guys will be able to see us in another episode soon. Drop a comment, like and subscribe, and we'll see you later.
Goodbye.
Peace.